Tuli's mother was killed. Panda was caught in the fence line of a commercial farm. Mulelo separated from the herd by a man-made fire. In Botswana, conservation success is increasingly coming at a cost. There are more elephants here than anywhere on Earth. More elephants to come into conflict with humans.
So these elephants are literally just crossing the road here, heading towards the river. And this is what people have to deal with. Just on that side, there's a whole community of people living.
Botswana's decision to ban hunting in 2014 was lauded by the West. Here in the heart of Eli country, there's a decidedly different view.
For your life, what would you like to happen to the elephants for you?
To kill them.
To kill them?
Yes.
Kenneth Moyoba says the tourism dollars don't come to villages like his, but the elephants do, destroying crops. The new government says its decision to bring back commercial hunting will solve the problem. By creating what it calls buffer zones between hunting reserves and local communities. But commercial hunters will target bull elephant deep in the wilderness, far away from people. The poachers are already here.
It's the last sanctuary for elephants in Africa. It's true wilderness. What we thought was a sanctuary is no longer, because poachers have discovered that this is an area where big bulls concentrate.
Elephant researcher Mike Chase is taking us to the slaughter. From the air, the attempt to conceal the carcasses is clear.
The X marks at the bottom.
On the ground, the evidence of the ongoing massacre is sickening.
The face looks to me it's just been chopped off.
Clearly, obvious signs of a poacher cutting the skull to access the tusks. But another obvious sign, of course, is that the spinal bone has been chopped by a very sharp machete or axe to paralyze the elephant.
Why did they do that?
Well, the elephant is still wounded. And in order to paralyze the elephant, then they can safely chop out the tusks while the elephant is still alive.
Chase has documented a 500% rise in fresh elephant carcasses in northern Botswana, many of them poached. Botswana says its elephant populations are stable, ready to be hunted.
If you go into Kasane village,
it's unbanned hunting. Now the government wants to unban ivory sales.
I would say yes, there has been an increase in poaching. That we admit.
You do admit that there's a poaching problem, then why are you trying to sell ivory onto the market, which has been shown to increase the levels of poaching in a zone?
Well, the whole world right now is closing those markets, and therefore the big question is, are we sitting on a ticking time bomb? Because when people eventually say, we are sick and tired of being zookeepers or gamekeepers, there is no return on investment, and then they go randomly out there and massacre them, then that is a real problem.
The question Botswana now asks itself, is an elephant worth more dead or alive?